Something super important talk is how diabetes can mess with your vision. We'll talk about why this happens and what you can do about it. Diabetes is a condition where your blood sugar levels are too high. This can cause a lot of problems in your body, including your eyes. When your blood sugar is high, it can affect the tiny blood vessels in your eyes. These vessels can get damaged and cause vision problems. Sometimes, the damage is temporary, but it can also be long-term. One of the first things you might notice if you have diabetes is blurry vision. This happens because high blood sugar can make fluid move in and out of the lens of your eye, causing it to swell. When the lens changes shape, it can't focus light properly, making your vision blurry. The good news is that this kind of blurry vision often goes away when your blood sugar levels return to normal. But, if your blood sugar stays high for a long time, it can cause more serious problems. One of the most common issues is diabetic retinopathy. This condition affects the retina, the part of your eye that senses light and sends signals to your brain so you can see. In the early stages, blood vessels in the retina can weaken and leak fluid. This stage is called non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy. If it gets worse, new, abnormal blood vessels can grow on the surface of the retina. This is called proliferative diabetic retinopathy and can lead to severe vision problems or even blindness. I will talk about diabetic retinopathy in more detail in this video later. Another serious issue is diabetic macular edema. The macula is the part of your retina that you need for seeing fine details, like reading or recognizing faces. When diabetes causes swelling in the macula, it's called diabetic macular edema. This can lead to partial vision loss or blindness if not treated. Wait, there is more, but do not forget to hit the like button if you have found this video useful so far. Thus, YouTube will serve more videos to suit your interest on similar topics. Glaucoma is another eye problem that people with diabetes are more likely to get. Glaucoma damages the optic nerve, which connects your eye to your brain. This can lead to vision loss and blindness if not caught early. Diabetes doubles your chances of developing glaucoma. Cataracts are also more common in people with diabetes. A cataract is when the lens of your eye becomes cloudy, making it hard to see clearly. People with diabetes tend to get cataracts at a younger age than those without diabetes. High blood sugar levels can cause deposits to build up in the lens, leading to cataracts. So, what can you do to protect your eyes if you have diabetes? First, keep your blood sugar levels under control. This is the best way to prevent or slow down the progression of eye problems. Regular eye exams are also crucial. Even if your vision seems fine, you should see an eye doctor at least once a year. They can catch problems early when they're easier to treat. If you're pregnant or planning to get pregnant, it's even more important to keep an eye on your vision. Pregnancy can make diabetic retinopathy worse, so you might need extra eye exams during this time. Smoking and high blood pressure can also make diabetic eye problems worse. So, if you smoke, try to quit. And keep your blood pressure under control by eating a healthy diet, exercising, and taking any medications your doctor prescribes. Sometimes, despite your best efforts, you might still develop serious eye problems. Treatments are available, but they work best when the problem is caught early. For example, laser therapy can help stop the growth of new blood vessels in proliferative diabetic retinopathy. Injections of medications into the eye can help reduce swelling in diabetic macular edema. Surgery might be needed for severe cases of glaucoma or retinal detachment. It's also important to know the symptoms of serious eye problems so you can get help quickly. If you notice any of these symptoms, see your eye doctor right away. Sudden blurry vision. Dark spots or strings floating in your vision, floaters. Fluctuating vision. Dark or empty areas in your vision. Loss of vision. Difficulty seeing at night. Colors that look washed out or different. Managing diabetes is a lifelong journey, but taking steps to protect your eyes can make a big difference. Keep your blood sugar, blood pressure, and cholesterol levels in check. Don't smoke, and make sure to get regular eye exams. If you do develop an eye problem, follow your doctor's advice and get the treatment you need. Remember, your eyes are precious. Taking care of them is a key part of managing your diabetes and living a healthy life. Wait, there is more, but do not forget to hit the like button if you have found this video useful so far. Thus, YouTube will serve more videos to suit your interest on similar topics. Diabetic retinopathy is a common complication of diabetes that affects the eyes. It progresses through several stages, each with increasing severity and potential for vision loss. Let's break down how this condition develops over time. Diabetic retinopathy starts when high blood sugar levels damage the small blood vessels in the retina, the light-sensitive tissue at the back of the eye. This damage can cause these vessels to leak fluid or bleed, leading to vision problems. The progression of diabetic retinopathy can be divided into four main stages. 1. Mild non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy, NPDR. This is the earliest stage. Small areas of swelling in the retina's blood vessels, known as microannuary SMS, occur. These microannuary SMS can leak fluid into the retina, causing mild retinal swelling. At this stage, there are usually no symptoms, and vision is typically not affected. 2. Moderate non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy. As the disease progresses, some of the blood vessels that nourish the retina become blocked. This blockage prevents proper blood flow, leading to more significant leakage of fluid and blood into the retina. Vision may start to become blurry if the macula, the central part of the retina responsible for detailed vision, is affected. 3. Severe non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy. At this stage, many more blood vessels become blocked, depriving large areas of the retina of their blood supply. The retina sends signals to grow new blood vessels to compensate for the lack of oxygen. These new blood vessels are not yet formed, but the retina is severely deprived of blood, increasing the risk of progression to the proliferative stage. 4. Proliferative diabetic retinopathy or PDR. This is the advanced stage of the disease. New, abnormal blood vessels begin to grow on the surface of the retina and into the vitreous gel inside the eye. These new vessels are fragile and can bleed easily, leading to severe vision problems. The bleeding can cause dark spots or floaters in the vision and may lead to the formation of scar tissue. Scar tissue can pull on the retina, potentially causing retinal detachment, which can result in permanent vision loss or blindness. The progression of diabetic retinopathy varies among individuals and depends on how well blood sugar, blood pressure, and cholesterol levels are managed. Regular eye exams are crucial for early detection and treatment, which can slow the progression and prevent severe vision loss. Symptoms of diabetic retinopathy often do not appear until the disease is advanced. These symptoms can include blurry vision, dark spots or floaters, fluctuating vision, dark or empty areas in vision, difficulty seeing at night. Managing diabetes effectively through a healthy diet, regular exercise, and medication can help prevent or slow the progression of diabetic retinopathy. Regular comprehensive eye exams are essential for early detection and treatment, which can significantly reduce the risk of severe vision loss. In summary, diabetic retinopathy progresses from mild stages with no symptoms to severe stages that can cause significant vision loss or blindness. Early detection and proper management of diabetes are key to protecting your vision. Consult your healthcare professional before changing your medication or lifestyle. Do not forget to click the like button and subscribe. Up above you see a few videos related to some other herbs important for diabetes and health. Thanks very much for watching this video. Subscribe to my channel. See you in the next video. None of the information provided by this video is a replacement for your physician's advice.